me. So I had a realization. When we got Apollo, I put a calendar notification in my phone for his 6 month anniversary with us. And it's this week. We've had Apollo 6 months. You have been, listener, he has been in our lives for 6 months. And my God, time has flown so quickly, it's unbelievable. And I just wanted to kind of like say happy anniversary, really, to him, but he's too preoccupied licking crap off the bottom of the shoes. And to celebrate our anniversary, I got him this little squeaky, sleepy dog, which kind of looks like him in the mornings when he comes crawling through and he's like, he's a very, very sleepy dog. Come on. Loves his meals already, don't you? Oh, I love you so much! I've grown up with dogs and I've had so many in the past. And the thing is that I've grown up with breeds like Dobermans and Rottweilers. And Andrew has had, he's had dogs as well. And we were kind of like, we knew we really wanted a rescue dog, and we trawled through so many rescue websites that kind of detail who they've got and things like that, and there were so many kind of small dogs that wouldn't be suitable for our lifestyle. It wouldn't be suitable to put them through the paces that we put him through. It would be unfair to have found somebody that's not him, wouldn't it? So basically, our friends have a whole load of Vizslas, and we fell in love with the breed, and we met this. It's not a breeder. We met this wonderful family who were breeding their one girl for the first and only time in her life, and it was kind of like, it felt a lot like the whole kind of selfish gene concept of satisfying your purpose in life by procreating. And so basically he was one of her breeds, so you were one of Effie's little babies, weren't you? And we went and saw him in mid-March, just after we got back from skiing, and we met this squidgy little, like, mushy puppy that was so cute, and your breed name was Lawrence, or his pedigree name was Lawrence. And so I was taking the piss out of it because it just seems like it's not a name that it's got a few connotations for me. And I just couldn't imagine having a dog called Lawrence. And then we went through all like name options and things like that. And we kind of like, we came up a bit empty. And when we had two Dobermans called Apollo and Zeus, after Magnum PI's two Dobermans. And I kind of thought, actually, I really like Apollo. So we called you, didn't we? Apollo Mark II. But he's been perfect. Having had dogs in the past, I had a lot of expectations of what our life would be like, and a lot of expectations and demands that they'd have on us. I kind of thought, well, I know Vizslas are known as Velcro dogs, and they're really soft and really, like, they just love, oh, they love so much attention, and I adore you so much, and we were like, oh, he's going to be really tactile, and I just thought, like, he'd want cuddles every now and then, or if he was out on the sofa, he'd just, like, attack you and jump on you and things. Get off me! I'm being pinned down by by this 30 kilogram lump. Hello, can you just either just get up? Come up here. Oh, get your ass up. Get your ass up. Go up. It's a mission. We had all of these, like, we'd read a lot about Vizslas and kind of made expectations, like, oh, he's gonna be like this, he's gonna be really cuddly, he's gonna want lots of attention, he's gonna want lots of love and all of that. And my god, did I underestimate everything that I read. Because, come here, he is like the most in love with you, dependent on like your love and approval and praise, and he is just the loveliest puppy in the world. So I had absolutely no idea. And do you know, our loft is actually really, it's not small, but it's very open plan. And so he lives in a crate just over there, and sleeps there at night, and it's like his kind of comfort zone. He's got all of his big cushions and like mats and everything like that, and he just loves being there. And then like our bedroom is around the corner, but it's like there's no doors or anything in between. It's just like long corridors and you kind of archways and things. So it's like the first month I was an absolute wreck, because anytime he cried, it would be like, oh, we're gonna go run through and get the puppy and make sure it doesn't pee up here, and we're gonna go see him. And every noise he made, we could hear. And that was really tough. He just really wanted to be around like another being. So he was just so dependent on kind of being around us and receiving cuddles and things like that. And I changed my work patterns and set myself up so that I could work from home, which has been great because I get to spend so much time with you, this man, and he's just like playing on my lap here, and he he's just lovely to be around. Sometimes he's an absolute pain in the backside. I've had to get used to the fact that any pair of shoes I own will get ruined. And I had this beautiful little pair of blue stilettos, and he ate them. He ate my shoes. He actually consumed my stiletto. Never going into bed, and I'm a health freak, and I was like, what if he pisses on his foot and then jumps into the bed and then we'll die of illness? And we kind of like set that out from the beginning, and we were like, he is never ever getting into bed with us. And then he came home with us on the first night. That's a bit of a bad precedent. So now in the mornings, if he wakes up at 6:30, it's normally after 6:30, I kind of let him out and I let him out of his crate, let him go to the loo, and then I let him in bed. And he runs through and has a massive cuddle with Andrew, and it's so cute, and it's just a perfect start to the day. Come here, come up. Of my slippers are ruined, my flip-flops. I've only got one flip-flop. Where the hell is my other Havana? Can you tell me that? Can you tell me? Can you explain to me? He nibbled my Rupert Sanderson. Yeah? Yeah. He nibbled my Rupert Sanderson little boots. But it's just been such a cool journey, and we, no matter what, we get out every single night. One of the things that I didn't anticipate having a puppy would be weight gain. My God, like for me, I've got puppy fat. Like we're used to like every night pre-puppy would be either go climbing to a climbing centre or outdoors, depending on like time of year and things. And it was also and it was also like we'd also go to the gym for an hour every single day. We were like crazy religious. And then we got him, and it changed because for the first 2 months first few weeks he wasn't allowed out because of his inoculations and things. And so it was like, oh, let's just stay in, put a film on, and watch some Big Bang, and we just wanted to be around you so much. And it was really tough. And then even now, our evening walks are limited to an hour because these are your little joints. We don't want to hurt you. No, we don't want to hurt you. So he is limited. And I haven't really been saying this. Should I say it? Should I wait to share your surprise? I'll wait. But yeah, so we're gonna have a long time ahead of us of like not being able to walk too far. Another thing I didn't anticipate that much would be all of this, would be the licking, would be all the kisses, because if a Doberman it would always be different when I was a kid, like with the kind of security dogs. I get through so many packs of hand sanitizer because of this, because of like the finger licking and the kisses, all of that. It's alright, I can get through hand sanitizer and hand wash. I wash my hands like 50 times a day. So I've had to be really careful finding hand wash that doesn't like erode us or anything. Holidays are great because we can take him with, like we've planned a lot of things purely with the intention of taking him. What else have you brought us? You brought us so much love, haven't you? And we absolutely adore you. It's given Andrew and I like cool responsibility. Not that we're irresponsible either. Not that we haven't had responsibility between us, but it's kind of given us dimensions of like accountability between each other. My parenting approach is completely different to his parenting approach. I'm so laissez-faire, but then sometimes that's quite bad because he can pick up bad habits, like just jumping on the sofa and like asking for food and things. Whereas Andrew's very structured and rigorous and things, which is completely balanced. I hate telling him off. I find that like I have a lot of patience, but then I'm just like, right, that's it, cross the line, I'm angry at you now. You can't be angry at a puppy. That's the most stupid thing to ever like try to do. And is it good paw? No paw. Down.
Good boy.
One of the great things is that the puppy teeth are all gone, and I would just get constantly lacerated by those little sharp teeth. Now like my skin is recovering and I don't look too victimized anymore. That's really sweet. What else? I've just absolutely loved having him in our lives, and I know I can completely speak for Andrew on this, in that Apollo, best thing that has happened to us so far in this journey. Vizslas are by far one of the best fruits of dog. I adore him so much. I kind of feel bad for, I wish that we weren't, like, I love being in Birmingham. Vizslas are by far one of, like, the best animals. Maybe it's just you, maybe it's just you, but there's a huge community and we're such dog people. I'm like dog person 101. Like, my friends are like, oh, when we're all catching up and things, we'll all talk about our different aspects of our lives, and I have to stop myself chirping in when they're talking about their babies. I have to stop myself kind of sharing stories of sleepless nights and things, because they don't really appreciate the fact that my dog is my little baby, aren't you? Our little baby. Yeah, we're like, come on, fake. I'm so dog person, it's ridiculous. We're looking for a holiday home for next summer, and the location was beautiful, and it was absolutely gorgeous. And I called them up, or called the owner up to kind of speak to them, and they were like, oh, we don't accept dogs. I was like, okay, would you accept dogs for a little bit more kind of a cleaning contribution? I was trying to bribe them, and they were like, no, we just have a blanket policy. We do not accept dogs in our, like, holiday house. I was like, well, thank you for your time, sir, and have a good day. But really, I wanted to tell him I'd shove him, because how dare he, which is completely irrational and stupid, but that is, like, literally how I feel. I adore him so much. I get protective over him. One of my scariest moments was last month when my car broke down. It broke down, like, in the Lake District, and it was like a BMW 1 Series, and it only had three doors, so he kind of like put the back seat down and he'd jump in, which is, like, fine. Then the RAC man came to tow us, and the car has to go backwards, because it's rear wheel drive, so it had to go, like, get mounted onto the tow backwards, and which meant that we couldn't be in it, and we had to go in the cab. I was like, okay, cool. I'll get his, like, seatbelt thing, and he can, like, strap in with us in the cab, and I'll hold on to him. And the guy was like, blanket policy, dogs aren't allowed. I was like, oh. And so he had to be in the car on his own. We left him strapped in, like, in his harness, like, into a seatbelt kind of converter. And then we were, like, driving through, like, towns and things, and the car had to be unlocked behind us, because otherwise the alarm would be going off all the time. And I was like hanging my head out the window to make sure that nobody, like, opens the door and steals him, because I was, like, neurotic. But in all honesty, we love him so much, and we have, like, we don't put him in harm's way, and he is, like, the best addition to our little family. Also, one of the surprising things about, like, that I've discovered about him, having had him in my life, is that he is a friggin' lazy dog. For, like, one of the world's fastest animals, he's so lazy, it's unbelievable. I tried to get him out of bed before lunchtime, and he moans. He's like, whoa, 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 whoa. He properly moans and whines about it. And he's never a happy bunny. When he has to get out of it, use hand sanitizer now. He's an incredibly lazy dog. One thing I didn't kind of know about Vizslas either was, like, their little greyhound mode. And they go into, like, the super fast run where they just, like, pelt it up and down. And it's so funny to see. Ah, don't eat my olive tree! Don't eat it! Also, my shrubs. Oh, God, in the terrace outside, he's eaten so many of my shrubs. He ate, oh, when he was just a few weeks old, he was so small and cute. And now he's just a big monster. He is so small and cute, so. He ate one of my peony plants. Like, he just destroyed it. And this, like, peony plant, I'm so attached to it. And he just So, I wasn't amused. But, do you know what? If I can sacrifice the peony plant, I can sacrifice anything for you. I think you're the best guy in the world. Come up here for a cuddle. Like cheesy hands and all. Like, come here. I just want to love your face. I want to love your face. Ugh! Ugh, the best dog. Ugh. He is so nice and I adore him so much. Oh, I love him and I just want to eat his ears. And I'm so grateful to have had you the last 6 months. And we are going to have so many more months and years and more sometimes. I adore you. I adore you. Oh, my ears. But. Yeah, obviously, like inviting a dog into your family is such a big decision. And if you're thinking about it, check the Dogs Trust website, check like the RSPCA, check like all your rescue centres locally, and just see what you can do, because there are so many of these little guys who just need so much love that.